In just about every single application out there, there'll be a need for a delay. The FreeRTOS provides a very cool delay. In order for us to leverage it, we'll need to include the FreeRTOS library. So we do it as follows. The actual tasks and what we can actually do with them, we will discover, we will go into much greater detail when we look at the FreeRTOS module. For now, let's go ahead and create a delay in the loop. In order for us to create a delay, we use the vTaskDelay. V because it returns void, in other words, it doesn't actually return anything. So that V is correlated to that vTask over there. And we can see that it actually takes a constant tick tock, which if we're going to look at it, we can see that it's a UINT32. So in other words, it's just an integer, it's a number. So I can come in here and I can say 1000. The question is 1000 what? And the answer is ticks. So this is not milliseconds, this is just the ticks, the frequency of the actual chip. If we want to actually convert that into milliseconds, we would need to do the following. We divide this number by port tick period milliseconds. This port tick period milliseconds is part of the hash defines that gets configured when we compile our application and is defaulted to how fast the chip is running. So 1000 divided by the amount of ticks that the chip is running will give us milliseconds. Now let's go ahead and print something out. So quite simply, I've created this variable called int I, and then I'm doing this ESP log I. Now notice this is something which I'm doing now so that I don't have to put in hard-coded values, is I'm using a hash define. When the application compiles, it'll replace that tag with whatever is in that hash define. So at the moment, it's just a string called delay. And then I'm printing out this in loop, and I'm just incrementing every single time I loop through this particular loop, I'm incrementing this number. So it'll be in loop 0, then in loop 1, and so on and so forth. Let's go ahead and give this a try. And here we can see it's printing out a new incremented number every second.